Hello, I'm Paulette Mahurin, your host today at R Ventura TV, and I'm thrilled to have here today Terry Mahurin, who is a pro bono attorney doing work in the self-help legal clinic in the courthouse in Ventura County. And Terry, I'm really thrilled to have you here today. You were a very, very high-powered attorney working for NASA. You were around the shuttle. You were around astronauts. You had a very sexy job. And now you're working with people that can barely afford to feed themselves in the courthouse, that are coming in, that can't afford an attorney. What was this transition like for you?
Well, Paulette, I'm very glad to be here today and talk about my volunteer experience and the transition from working in the government corporate world to the volunteer world. NASA is a lot of fun, but it is a day-to-day job, an 8-to-5 job every day, doing with a lot of routine activities. Volunteering in the courthouse is entirely different. Every day is different when I'm there, dealing with a different group of people, many of whom would have no recourse to any sort of legal assistance for their problems if they didn't come to the courthouse, where we do offer free legal assistance to them.
Well, now, what kind of assistance do you actually offer? Because I understand there are several different divisions of free services in the courthouse. For instance, the self-help legal clinic that you're with does what specifically, and who can come to you for these services?
Okay. The self-help legal clinic I volunteer in does civil matters. The primary ones are evictions and civil harassment restraining orders. We also do name changes, expungements for infractions and misdemeanors, and a variety of other little civil matters. But we do no criminal, no small claims, nor family law matters, i.e. divorce, alimony, child visitation. Those are handled by separate areas in the courthouse.
Okay, now before we go on to any of these separate areas, you mentioned a big word, and I'm not quite sure what it means, but you said expungement. So if there's somebody out there that needs something expunged, what would they need and what would you be doing for them?
Okay, expungements is a process where you have a conviction changed to a dismissal.
Okay, so that's like clearing your record?
That's correct.
And so they can come to you to fill out these forms?
That's correct.
That's great. That's great. Well, now, how many people do you see a day when you're there on any given day?
Somewhere between 25 and 40 people come in.
And does everybody that comes gets to be serviced, or do you have that you have to have them come back, waiting lines and so forth?
It depends. Depends upon whether they fall in the categories of areas we can assist them with, and also depends upon our workload for that day. We're open from 8 to 12 and 1:30 to 4, and that means we can only handle so many people during a day.
All right, but if everybody comes to you with a civil matter, can you handle everybody that comes to you, or do you tell them to come back the next day, or how does that work?
We try to handle them if we can, but sometimes due to workload or crowds of people, we do have to ask them to come back the next day.
And how long would somebody need to wait if they really have a pressing matter and they need to come in to see you? I would imagine people come to you desperate.
They do, and we try to take people, they come in a first-come, first-served basis, and so we try to get them in as fast as possible. But sometimes they may have to wait a half an hour, 45 minutes if a lot of people are coming in, or the people we're currently serving have complex issues.
Okay, now what if we forget what you do in the self-help legal clinic? Is there a centralized area in the courthouse where somebody can go to find out where to be directed and where different services are?
Yes, there is. You go into the main lobby at the main courthouse in Ventura and explain to them your problem, and they'll send you either to us or to one of the three other areas.
Okay, and what are the three other areas?
Small claims, which are lawsuits up to $10,000. Criminal matters, which are handled by a public defender. Or there's a family law self-help for dissolutions of marriages, divorces, child support, alimony that fall out of that.
Okay, and all of these services are free?
That's correct.
All right. Now, I also understand that in addition to your volunteering in the self-help legal clinic, you're looking into helping in another one of these areas. Do you want to talk a little bit about that?
Sure. I'm looking into becoming a mediator in small claims court.
And what would that involve? And if somebody needed your service, how could they contact you, or how could they set up making an appointment with small claims court if they needed to go there. And while you're answering that, could you just explain a little bit about who can be serviced in small claims court, what it's about?
Okay, small claims courts handles basically money matters up to a maximum of $10,000.
Like what would be an example of a money matter?
I loan you money and you don't pay it back to me.
Oh.
I'm suing you because you didn't pay back the money.
Okay.
You run into my car in the parking lot. My bill for getting repaired is $3,000. I sue you for that $3,000.
Okay, so it's like Judge Judy on television.
Yes.
Okay.
More or less.
Okay, good. I think we can all relate to that.
Yes, we can.
Okay, so you're going to, so what's the difference between if you're a judge in the court and you would be mediating? How would people contact you for that?
Okay, you don't contact us for mediation. What happens, you get set up for an appointment in the small claims court, and the judge decides if he's going to send you to mediation during that day you're in court.
Mm-hmm.
And he has mediators on staff who are waiting. So rather than him deciding the case, you'll have the mediators go outside and see if you can resolve it. And if you can resolve it between the two parties with the assistance of the mediator, then you come back to the judge and say, we've resolved it. Here's how we resolved it. He ratifies it, and that's the end of it.
So you would just help expedite the system, which I understand is backlogged months. It takes a long time to get into court nowadays, huh?
For a regular civil matter, it does, yes.
Yeah, so you're doing volunteer work is a blessing. Are there a lot of attorneys helping out doing mediation work?
There's a number doing mediation work, yes, and there's a lot of attorneys helping out in other aspects in the courthouse.
That's great, and I understand you don't need to be an attorney to do mediation work.
That's correct. You have to take a class in mediation.
So anybody could do that if they meet the requirements?
That's correct.
Okay, so there seems like there's a lot of great opportunities to help where there are needs. Now, what made you decide that you wanted to do this volunteer work instead of continuing on and working as a paid attorney? I mean, this is fascinating that you're giving so much of your time to help the people of Ventura County. Tell us.
Well, when I left NASA, I decided I wanted to keep myself involved with legal matters, but I didn't want to get involved in a day-to-day job. And I like the flexibility of volunteering. I go in one day a week. If I can't make it, I call them, let them know I'm not going to be there. And the other aspect of it is I like to give back to society.
Mm.
Society has given me a lot of my life. This is a manner I can use the training that I have to give back to society, to people who may not otherwise be able to serve in our legal system.
Well, trust me, I'm sure a lot of people are very grateful that you are doing this pro bono, because there is such a need out there. There's such a need for volunteers. And how do you feel doing the volunteer work? Has it been stimulating to you? Would you like to communicate just on that aspect of it? I'm sure there's so many different available opportunities for people out there and people that are lonely and wondering what to do.
I particularly love to do the courthouse because I enjoy the legal work. But if you're interested in volunteering, there's hospitals, there's libraries, there's theaters, there's museums, schools. There's a multitude of opportunities for volunteering. So if you like to get out and volunteer, find something to interest you. Contact the organization and see what their needs are and see if you can contribute to them.
Yeah, that's great. And also along that line, I understand you're doing volunteer in a totally separate non-legal capacity. You want to speak a little bit to that?
Oh, yes. I'm doing two other things in particular.
Yeah.
I'm volunteering with AARP to help people do their income taxes.
For free?
For free.
So this is an AARP program. Is it just for seniors?
No, it's not. Anyone can use it.
Anyone, let me just get this straight. Anyone can go to you through the AARP program and get their taxes done for free?
Yes, with certain exceptions. There are certain limitations, one of which is you have to be a full year resident of California.
Okay.
It has to be an individual and not a business tax.
Okay.
And if you're married, it has to be a joint return.
Wow. Well, this is fun. I didn't know about this. So how would people find you? How would people get the service?
Go to the AARP website. Last year, there were 9 locations in Ventura County that offered this service.
Wow, that's great. That's great. And you mentioned you had another area that you were also volunteering in?
Oh, yes. I volunteer with dogs. with the Canine Adoption Rescue League here in Ventura County.
Oh, fantastic. Yes, they do the annual Pooch Parade, and they've adopted out thousands and thousands of dogs. I think they're one of the longest running rescue animal groups for dogs specifically in Ventura County. This is terrific. How did you land doing this?
I've always liked dogs. And when my wife and I moved to Ojai, we looked into something we could do with dogs. And we got connected with the Canine Adoption Rescue League. So with them, I've walked dogs, I've worked in the adoption center, and more recently, I've worked on their annual Pooch Parade.
Wow. So it sounds like you're keeping yourself pretty busy doing all these things.
Yes, I am.
Yes, fantastic. Now, I see, Terry, that we're almost out of time. And before we actually wrap up, I'd love to know if there's something that you'd like to say to the audience about your volunteer work or about coming into the courtroom or anything that you'd like us to hear.
I find volunteering is extremely rewarding to me, not only intellectually for keeping me active, but to give. It makes me feel good and makes me feel good about society. And there's nothing more rewarding for me in the courthouse seeing someone comes who's lost and don't know where they're going, and demystify the system and help them see their options and their choices, give them the right forms to fill out and review them, give them a fee waiver so they don't have to pay the court fees. It warms my heart. I feel really good about it.
Well, I feel really good about it. Trust me that I've learned about all these services, and I'm sure there are a lot of people out there that feel the same, and I think you've done an enormous service to give attorneys a good name today, Terry. So thank you so much for volunteering and for coming in here and talking about it with us today. And I am Paulette Mayhurin, your host at R Ventura TV. I'm thrilled to have Terry with us today, but I'm also thrilled that he came to talk about volunteering, and hopefully it will inspire people out there, all of you, to take a look and see if there's something that you can do that might help the community, and in return, help your own heart and help you feel good, because it's wonderful to connect up and be a part of something. So until we meet again, keep watching R Ventura TV.